Good night, Dani.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. Hello, hello.
Hello,
Hello,
teacher.
Miss. Good evening.
Hi, everybody. How are you? How is your Monday? ¿Cómo les va en el lunes, inicio de semana? How do you feel?
Very, very good.
Very good. Okay. Nice. Good to hear that. And I'm really happy to see you here. So, guys, let me see. Thank you so much for being on time. So, I see Norberto, Anthony, Josie, Sandra, Martinez, Rivera. I don't know who you are. Let me see. I got Martinez. Oh, Patricia. Okay. Thank you so much. And Moises. Hello, Moises. Thank you for joining today. So I hope you're having a really nice Monday. Ingrid and Jacobo, right? Okay. Miss Miriam, solo.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hello, Miriam. So Jacobo es su apellido.
Yes, Miriam Claribel Jacobo.
Okay, okay. I saw Jacobo and I was like, ¿qué pasó? Who is this person? Until I saw your name. Sorry about that. Okay. Okay. So thank you so much. So everybody, I'm super happy to see you. Super happy that we are about to start nuestra segunda semana, right? Week number two, el corazoncito del módulo, like second week, y ya casi termina, right? Gracias también por la responsabilidad con las tareas. I truly appreciate that. Estaba revisando el reporte, you know, y todos tienen como 100, 92, 93, pero excelente trabajo. Very nice. So I'm really happy about it. Esta semana vamos a movernos ya con los temas. Tenemos como una semana un poquito más, no pesada, sino en el sentido de más llena de contenido, you know, más vocabulario. So new words, new vocabulary, para que podamos practicar and we can continue, you know, the process in which we are right now. So, como siempre lo hacemos, voy a pasar primero asistencia, right? Antes de irnos ya con la agenda and everything. ¿Qué vamos a estar haciendo? Give me one second here. Solo les tomo aquí rapidito. Let me take it here. In the meantime, guys, cuéntenme qué hicieron el fin de semana. What did you do? ¿Alguien salió? ¿Alguien fue a caminar? Did you stay in your house? ¿Vieron alguna película?
Fue a jugar fútbol y casi me muero porque no había jugado mucho tiempo.
El cansancio. Ok, pero me alegra que esté bien, right? Y que no haya fallecido en el intento. No, just kidding. I'm really happy that you made it. Ok, so that is exercise. Guys, ¿y los demás cómo les fue? How was it? ¿Qué hicieron?
Yo estoy super happy, teacher.
¿Por qué, Miss? ¿Qué hizo? Cuéntenos.
Ay, me celebraron mi cumple.
¡Ay, happy birthday! Nice. Happy birthday. That's super good. Okay.
Gracias, Dani.
There was a party. Okay. Nice. Okay, give me one second. Okay, primero de febrero. So let me go ahead and take notes. So I got Ana Delmi.
Present, teacher.
Delmi. Thank you, Miss. Brenda Magna. Brenda, todavía no. Brian. Está por aquí Brian. Creo que no. Cindy Janet. Cindy, ¿está por acá? No, verdad. Danny Anthony. There you go. Thank you. Daisy Lorena. No la veo por acá. Gabriela Alejandra. Giovanni Enrique.
Present.
Thank you, Giovanni. Got Hansel. Hansel. And Ingrid Magali. Creo que por ahí vi a Ingrid. Yes, thank you. Jocelyn Melissa. Jocelyn Lisbeth.
I am here, teacher.
Thank you so much. José Norberto.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, José. Marvin Alexander. Marvin, todavía no, right? It's not here. I see Miriam Claribel.
Present, miss. Ya cambié el nombre. No me había dado cuenta que estaba diferente.
No, no se preocupe. I mean, it was my bad. Solo me llamó la atención. No sabía que Jacobo era un apellido. Siempre lo había visto como nombre. So
ajá, sí, sí, también hay nombre.
Moisés Eduardo. Thank you, Moisés. Patricia Beatriz. Patricia.
Present, teacher. Present, so present, much. Present.
René. René Osvaldo.
Present.
Thank you, René. And Sandra Abigail. Rodas.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. All right. So thank you, everybody, for being on such time, you know. Gracias por la puntualidad a todos. And, well, vamos a empezar a trabajar. Tenemos como un par de cositas para ahora. Así que let me present my screen. Vamos con la sesión número 6 de 20. Okay. So vamos a empezar a trabajar con la unidad número 2. Okay. What are we going to check today? We are going to be able to talk about jobs, occupations, and work using simple present tense. Hemos estado trabajando con el verbo to be, okay? Ahora vamos a trabajar un poquito ya con otros verbos, no solamente verb to be, sino con like cualquier acción, any action, okay? Any activity that we have. So, para dar inicio, I have here a little exercise for you all. And the exercise is basically... Give me 1 second. Yeah, this is the exercise. So the exercise is basically to match. Okay, vamos a hacer como una especie de matching. Okay, vamos a parearlas. We have here some jobs y tenemos la descripción de qué es lo que hacen. Maybe, puede que algunos sean nuevos, right? Pero if you pay attention, hace falta uno, hace falta un empleo. So you have to read it y también intentar adivinar cuál es el que falta, okay? For example, we have janitor, we have surgeon, we have a lawyer, and we have a lifeguard, okay? Si alguno de ellos es nuevo para ustedes, no se preocupen, no worries. Revisen en el diccionario rapidito, okay? Janitor, ¿qué significa janitor? Para que tengamos una idea. Y también usamos los recursos que tenemos a la mano, right? So, you have a person who cleans buildings, a person who performs surgeries, a person who works at the beach, a person who fixes cars, and a person who defends people in court. Pero hace falta uno. Hay 5 descripciones here. Here, solo hay 4. Falta un empleo, all right? So, les voy a dar más o menos 5 minutitos. I will give you 5 minutes. Si terminan antes, solo me dicen, right? Let me know as you always do, like don't finished, okay? Para saber que ya están terminando, right? To know that you finished. So, 5 minutitos. 5 minutes, everybody. Let's go for it. Hi, Marvin. I'm happy to see you. Welcome. I'm happy que ya pudo ingresar. Thank you so much.
Ya estamos, ya estamos.
Awesome. Thank you, thank you. Let me see. Patricia is done. René is done. Okay, very good. That's okay. Déjenme ver quién más ya nos acompaña. Daisy, ¿me logré escuchar, Daisy? Todavía tiene dificultades con el audio. Hey, Brian. I'm happy to see you, Brian. Gaby, thank you for joining as well. Daisy? Creo que Daisy no tiene audio. Give me one second. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Moises. That's okay. Okay. I'm glad to see that. No sé, Daisy, si no me escucha, le escribí en el chat. Solo me confirma, please. Then she doesn't have water. Okay. Okay, guys. So let's take a look. Remember, también íbamos a identificar cuál es... Oh, okay. I'm happy to see that. Thank you, Daisy. So también íbamos a identificar cuál era el occupation que falta, right? The one that is missing. So let's take a look here. Help me, please. Janitor. What is the description of a janitor?
So, person who cleans building and office.
Very nice. Exactly. A janitor is a person who cleans buildings and offices. So si ustedes están en una oficina, all right? Y hay alguien encargado de la limpieza, that's a janitor. We call the person janitor. Surgeon, what is the description of a surgeon? ¿Qué hace?
Person who performs surgery.
Yes, perfect. You got it. Exactly. A person who performs surgeries. A surgery es una cirugía, right? Sorry about the noise. Lawyer. What about lawyer? What does a lawyer do?
Person who works at the beach and saves people.
A lawyer?
Person who defends people in the court.
Okay, a person who defends people in court. Very good. And a lifeguard? What does a lifeguard do?
Person who works at the beach and saves people.
Exactly. So lifeguard, like the Baywatch, los guardianes de la bahía, right? They are lifeguards. So, but there is one job that is missing. What is missing? ¿Qué hace falta? There is one that is missing.
Mechanic.
Yeah, all right. Let's take a look. We are missing, yes, exactly, mechanic. So a mechanic is a person who fixes cars. Very good. Yes. So we have mechanic. Everybody, please, let's repeat. Repeat after me. Mechanic.
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 Janitor.
Mechanic.
Mechanic.
Janitor.
Surgeon. Lawyer.
Lifeguard.
So that's a lifeguard. Exactly. Okay. So guess the topic, occupations and activities. So we are going to be checking a couple of things, okay, that we normally do. So I have this part, right? 5 activities you do at work. vamos a hacer como una listita, right, de las actividades que nosotros hacemos, all right? So, for example, I can tell you, oh, I am a teacher. So, estas son mis actividades. These are my activities. I write reports. Si ustedes las hacen, pueden también decir, I write reports. I make phone calls. Cuando es necesario, I make phone calls, okay? I am in charge of. That means estoy a cargo de, all right? Si usted está a cargo de alguna actividad en específico, I am in charge of. Estoy a cargo de, I don't know, abrir la oficina, for example. I am in charge of opening, okay? The building, opening the office. I check on students' progress, all right? But again, estas son mis actividades. These are my activities. What about you guys? What do you do? Okay, creo que no les he preguntado a todos, no sé el empleo de todos, you know, pero ahora lo vamos a descubrir. So what do you do and what are your activities? Write 5 activities you do at work. Les voy a dar un par de minutitos para que podamos escribirles. So, ¿qué hacen? What do you do? Okay, I write, I make. Si necesitan ayuda con alguna, let me know o me escriben en el chat, please, para que todos we check on that together. Podemos usar como I write, I make, yo hago esto, right, etcétera, etcétera. So, les doy 5 minutitos para que hagamos como una listita. ¿Qué hacen, guys? What do you do? So if si necesitan ayuda, please let me know.
Teacher, ¿cuál es el significado de la última? ¿Quién apaga el micrófono, teacher?
Yeah, guys, can you hear me now? ¿Ahora sí me escuchan?
Sí, sí.
Ah, okay. Sí, thank you so much. Yeah, no sé qué le pasaba, no me dejaba desactivar el mute. Y me preguntaba de la última, this one, I check on the students' progress.
Sí, sí.
Okay, yes. This is because es como un ejemplo bien personal, right? como reviso el progreso de cada uno de ustedes. I check on my students' progress. But of course, no necesariamente va a aplicar a ustedes. A menos que fueran teachers, fueran como coaches, facilitadores, o su empleo tiene que ver con alguna área académica, I would say esto aplicaría. De lo contrario, no, I wouldn't do that. O tal vez si tienen como a cargo desarrollo de personal, sí aplicaría, como I check on employees, progress, right? Ahí sí se podría. Brian, veo que tiene una pregunta con, me encargo de corregir errores en los reportes. Se le escribo en el chat. Oigan, I'm going to write it in the chat. Patricia, I'm writing to you in the chat. Give me 1 second. Okay, guys. Almost ready. Necesitan más tiempo? Do you need more time? 1 minute, minutes. Guys, talk to me. Say hello to me. So how much time do you need? Okay, Marvin is done. Thank you, Marvin. Thank you, Jacqueline. Misterios. Okay. Thank you, Norberto. Okay. Moises, I see Jackie. It's all right. Okay. Sigo hablando en mute. Thank you so much for the confirmation. I see there are a lot of don'ts in the chat, so that's very good. I see Anna also finished. All right. That's okay. That's okay. So listen up, everybody. What we will do is the following now. Vamos a ir en grupos, all right? Y vamos a llenar el siguiente chart that I'm going to give you here. It says, choose 4 job positions, okay, from the previous exercise and write the person's name on that position. Lo que vamos a hacer es esto. Here we have name, job position, and other tasks. Okay? So, los compañeros nos van a decir, hi, my name is Giovanni. I am a, all right? I am an accountant. I am a lawyer. I am an insurance agent. I am an administrative assistant. I am a supervisor. I am a manager, etc. Y luego le van a decir, ¿qué es lo que hacen? What do they do? Y simplemente decimos, okay, so I am an accountant. I check books, I pay people's salary, okay, y todas las actividades. Y lo vamos a ir llenando dentro de nuestro cuaderno, right? So vamos a escribir name, job position, que es lo que hacen, and then other tasks. ¿Cuáles son las actividades específicas que ellos hacen? Al menos here tenemos como 5, pero con 2 que escribamos, we are perfect. We are super set, okay? Questions? Any question on this?
Una pregunta, Miss.
Yes, tell me.
Eso no está en el material para ver si se pueden en la unidad 2.
Eso está dentro de la unidad 2. Ya le confirmo que el número de página es la
página. En la página 19.
Gracias, exacto. 19. La página número 19. Thank you so
much. Ahorita, gracias.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome. Tal vez acá lo ve diferente por el tamaño, right? Y pues ya está sacado el libro. Pero sí, todo esto está dentro de su material. Page number 19. Mm-hmm. I like it. Ya tiene su material. Nice. Yes, miss, tell me.
¿Qué quiere decir other text? ¿Qué era eso?
Yeah, so we have name, job position. Here, in job position, solo decimos como I'm a teacher, right? And in other tests, sí decimos qué es lo que hacemos. So in this case, it's like, ¿qué es lo que ustedes hacen? What do you do?
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Lo que acabamos de escribir lo vamos a decir acá en other classes.
Okay, thank you. Yes,
you're welcome. Anybody else? No more questions?
No, no, teacher. Okay.
Si tienen alguna pregunta en el proceso, remember, podemos siempre presionar el botoncito que dice como ayuda, right? Or help. So, es como si
help me, teacher.
Yeah, exacto. El botoncito es lo que hacen. En vez de gritar, es como, te llama, right? So, I can go there and I can help you. So, everybody, I'm going to start this. Please, preguntémosle a los compañeros, as your classmates, o demos tanta información como podamos, right? So, let's go, please. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Empecemos. Voy a preguntar yo a Ana Delmi.
Okay.
Sí. What is your name?
My name is Ana Delmi.
What do you do?
I am customer service.
Other tax?
Send email.
Okay.
Answer calls.
Phone call.
Uh-huh. And I am in charge of file. I am in charge of file. Encargada de archivo.
Okay. That's it.
Only that.
Okay. And you, Giovanni, Enrique?
I am an accountant.
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 Giovanni Enrique.
Giovanni Enrique.
Tell me, other tasks.
I write reports.
Okay.
I make accounting.
Okay.
Repeat, please.
I make accounting.
Thank you.
Esto no sé muy bien cómo se pronuncia, pero I check the financial situation of the company. I check the financial situation of the company.
Okay. ¿Quién sigue?
Meli. Hello. Ingrid.
Hola.
Bueno, yo soy, tengo la misma ocupación que Meli, pero lo tengo diferente, pero igual, si quieres, si quieren anotarlo.
Yo creo que no, nos unimos las tres cajeras porque lo mismo hago, compañero.
Ah, pero está bien. Meli, bueno, yo no me recuerdo, no sé si Ingrid sabe, pero Meli, ¿te recordás cómo se dice que cobramos en POS, cobramos con tarjeta de crédito? Yo no me recuerdo, lo tenía anotado y ya no lo encuentro.
Teacher, ayúdanos.
I heard
teacher, está por ahí. Hello, teacher.
Tiene TV. Fíjense que tiene TV.
Teacher, how do you say cobre con tarjeta de crédito? I don't remember.
Pero es como cobro.
I charge. Ay, ¿cómo era?
What do you do? ¿Qué hacen?
Aquí nos juntamos las tres cajeras.
Las tres cajeras.
Oh, okay. You are cashiers. Oh, yes. Okay. But you do a lot of things. You use the POS.
Otra cosa puede ser también el closure report. Cierre de caja. Los reportes de cierre de caja, closure report.
End of the year. Well, you have the end of the day reports.
Closure reports. Reports.
Mm-hmm. Pueden ser como end of the day. End of the day reports.
Eso que quiere decir, teacher. On the day reports. Los reportes de cada día.
President. Okay. Asistente de residencia.
Qué chévere, Gavin. ¿Qué empresa trabajas?
Hi. Hi, con El Salvador.
Secret, no. Secretary. No.
No, sería como en el recursos humanos, ¿no?
Como mano derecha de presidente.
Algo así como mano derecha del jefe, del dueño de la empresa.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Qué chévere, súper chévere.
Qué responsabilidad. Qué gran responsabilidad, compañera.
Demasiado, pero ahí vamos. A mis 20 años progresando ya en ese puesto.
Muy bien. Felicidades. Te metes como secretary casi.
Pero hace un montón sí fui cajera, me acuerdo.
Ahí se las estás escuchando de que estábamos hablando las tres cajeras nada más.
Sí.
Entonces tomemos los datos de Gaby, que es lo más distinto de nosotros.
Ok.
Sí, me parece genial.
Ah.
Welcome back. Hi, everybody, and thank you for coming back. So I was, you know, listening to most of the groups talking about the activities, and it sounds incredible. I like it. We have lawyers. We have cashiers. I know that we have accountants. What else? What other job did you remember? I know that these three guys, Rene, Marvin, and Brian, you are insurance agent, I remember.
Yes.
I heard customer service agent. Any other job? ¿Qué más se me escapó por ahí? Any other job that
Gabriela is secretary.
Okay, so we got secretaries. Mm-hmm. What else? Any other job?
Sandra Rodas, she's manager.
Oh, okay. So we got a manager, we get a secretary, we have administrative assistant and executive assistant. Okay. What else?
Jose Navarro is cashier.
Okay. Cashier. All right. All right. That's okay. Any other job? Danny, what do you do? I'm sorry, Patricia. Anthony's.
Okay, sorry. Danny Anthony Sigüenza is accounting of company.
Really, Danny? So you're an accountant?
Yes, teacher. I am writing reports and treasure and my phone card and business. I am accounting of the company.
Okay, so I got accounting. All right, so
remember Moises is a supervisor.
Moises is a supervisor. Ah, okay, nice. That's okay. So Giovanni is an accountant, right? Giovanni?
Marvin is an insurance agent.
Mm-hmm. Marvin, yeah, he's an insurance agent. Let me see, who am I missing? Daisy, what do you do, Daisy?
Accountant.
So Daisy is an accountant. Giovanni is an accountant, and Danny is an accountant. So we got three accountants. Okay. I see that Jackie, Ingrid, Norberto, I believe, and Miriam, they are cashiers, right?
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Jocelyn is bad. He's a salesperson.
Ah, okay. Jocelyn is a salesperson, and I'm missing Delmi.
What do you do, Brenda?
Oh, Brenda, I think she won't be able to listen to you. Estaba teniendo dificultades, but I think she will come back. Oh, Sandra también está teniendo un par de dificultades.
What did you do, Sandra?
Okay. Pero alguien mencionó que Sandra is a manager, I think. No recuerdo quién lo mencionó, but I think I heard.
Yes, teacher, Sandra Rodas.
is manager.
Yeah, right. Okay, so Sandra is a manager. All right, nice. I like it because we got different occupations here. But the point is, what do they do? All right. So, for example, let's talk about Sandra because that's a different job. She is a manager. What does she do, guys? What does Sandra do? Any volunteer? What does Sandra do? ¿Escucharon las actividades que Sandra hace? The tasks?
Teacher, yes. Yo solo pude copiar check the restaurant. Porque lo
solo se mencionó.
Oh, okay, so she checked the restaurant. No, but it's okay, that's okay.
She checked out the restaurant.
Okay, she checks the restaurant. I got accountants, boys, and Daisy, what do you do? I got a lot of accountants here. So what do you do, guys? Giovanni, I see your microphone is open. So tell us, Giovanni, what do you do?
I am an accountant teacher.
Mm-hmm. So what are the main activities you do?
Okay. I make accounting.
Okay.
I write reports.
Okay.
I check the financial situation of the company.
Okay. Do you make the payroll? ¿Hace la planilla? Do you make the payroll?
Yes.
Okay. So you also made the payroll. And that's a very important task. Because that means salary and money. Okay. So I make the payroll. The payroll is la planilla. So that's a very important task, I would say. All right. For all accountants, right? So that's very important. Let me see. I'm missing Gabby. Gabby, I think you are an executive assistant, right?
Yes.
What is the main activity you do? Or the most important?
¿Cómo es que se le dice? ¿Cómo atender a los clientes?
Customer service, provide customer service.
Ajá.
Okay, that sounds very nice. All right. So everybody's got different activities. And now let's continue practicing because I want you to get like pretty close y que practiquemos this as much as we can. So give me 1 second here and tenemos lo siguiente. We got the following. Unit number 2, describe the activities that I perform every day at work. So, ¿cuáles son algunas? Ya los mencionaron ustedes. Accountant, executive assistant, salesperson, etc. So, it says here, tenemos un par de jobs, okay? We have bookkeeper, we have financial analyst, human resource specialist, digital marketing manager, insurance agent, que acá tenemos insurance agent, and software engineer, okay? So, vamos a hacer un pequeño matching exercise. Vamos a matchar here los empleos que tenemos, the jobs we got, con la descripción. Hagámoslo todos juntos to make it better, okay? Number 1, keep track of the financial accounts of company. What do you think? ¿Qué piensan de eso? ¿Cuál es?
Bookkeeper.
Letter B, sis.
Ah, okay. No. So letter A, bookkeeper, and letter B, financial analyst, okay? Digamos que es entre ellas.
Letter A.
Bookkeeper. Okay. So, votemos. Let's vote.
Letter A.
Okay, let's vote. In the chat, everybody, A or B. So, everybody, let's have your vote in the chat, A or B.
Ya estoy dudando.
No dude, don't hesitate. Okay, veo una letter A, los demás guys, come on. A or B, make a decision. A or B, what do you think?
A.
Los demás pongan como I don't know, no sé, or something. Okay, but tell me something. I don't know, es como yo no sé. All right, no estoy segura. I don't know. Okay, A, all right. Thank you so much, Marvin. That's okay. Okay, yes, the answer is A, bookkeeper. Exactly, I keep track of financial accounts. Good. Number 2, help people in business manage their finances. Number two, what is number two?
Number two is letter C.
Human resources specialist. This is like people in business, people in business, manage, como a organizar, right? Manage.
B?
Letter B.
Letter B, a financial analyst.
B. It's my name.
It's okay. Letter C. It's letter C.
Letter C, human resources specialist. Okay, so what do you think? Okay, la dejamos para después and we continue. It's okay, it's totally fine. Number three, know the policies and regulations involved in management of employees. Now we are talking about one company. So in one
insurance agent.
Okay, okay, wait a second. Brian, you are an insurance agent. What do you do? Do you know the policies involving the management of employees?
Yes.
What are your obligations? What are your responsibilities?
I write reports, I check correct accident report, I send weekly, bi-weekly, and monthly report to my boss. So,
but this is in case of an accident, right?
I check report like Rene and Marvin.
So you only check the reports, but
only Saturday I attend the accidents.
Okay, but the reports are about accidents, not about employees, right? You don't work in one company, but you work outside. So hay diferentes tipos de insurance, right? So puede ser por accidente, puede ser accidente de auto, por ejemplo, in a company, etc. But let's take a look at this. It says, know the policies. Policies, estamos hablando de como las reglas. En su empresa, ustedes tienen como reglas de convivencia. Eso se llama policies, right? Regulaciones. So policies no tienen nada que ver con la policía. So that's just to clarify this part, okay? Policies son reglas, okay? Now, know the policies. Alguien que conoce las reglas. Somebody who knows the policies. No hablamos de gobierno, no hablamos de nada.
Human.
Exactly, letter C. Human resources specialist. Because it says involved in the management of employees. Letter C, very good. Number five, help people in companies. Help people in companies against financial loss and manage risks. What is this?
Letter D.
Digital marketing manager. It says against financial loss. Loss es como la pérdida de dinero. Letter F, software engineer. Letter?
So what can
help people in companies?
Letter E,
that is an insurance agent, exactly, because they help people and they help companies against managed risks. Risk es como los riesgos, pérdidas y riesgos, right? So yeah, that is an insurance agent, letter E. So guys, es una descripción de lo que ustedes hacen as well. Number four, dejemos las dos para después. Number four. Create and advertise the company over the social media. What is this?
Letter D.
Very good. Letter D. We got it. And number six, design and develop different softwares. What is this?
Letter F.
Engineer. Now, help people in business manage their finances. What is number two? ¿Cuál no mencionamos?
Letter D, sis.
Letter B, B as in Bravo. Yes, financial analyst. So number one is a bookkeeper. Number two is a financial analyst. Number three is human resources specialist. Number four is a digital manager. Number five is an insurance agent. And number six is a software engineer. Very good. So these are part of the things, part of the activities that we do, okay? We create, we advertise, we design, we develop, etc. Now, vamos a empezar un poquito en cosas que nosotros no hacemos, que no es parte de nuestras obligaciones, all right? Alguien quizás puede decir, pero te toca a vos, and you say, no, eso yo no lo hago, okay? No es mi responsabilidad. Let's take a look at the following thing, because we are going to, it's important that we take a look at the grammatical component as well. Allow me a second, and I'm gonna show you. We have affirmative statements, and we have negative statements, okay? Y vemos algo diferente here. We see something different, right? If we pay attention, we have affirmative statements. I keep track of the financial account. Negative, ya no vemos el verbo to be, yeah? Ya no está verbo to be. But it says, I don't keep track of the financial accounts. So let me explain this a little bit further. Let me give you like more details on this. ¿Cómo expreso entonces las actividades que yo hago? How do I express those activities? It's very easy. Si yo hago una actividad, solamente digo, por ejemplo, yo reviso reportes, I check reports. Y eso es todo. That's very easy, super easy. ¿Qué sucede con las cosas que yo no hago? All right. For example, let me think about activities that I don't do. Por ejemplo, yo no trabajo con dinero. All right. Yo no manejo dinero. All right. So I don't handle money. All right, finance, let's say, manage. Voy a usar la palabra manage, que es como de organizar, you know, de manejar, all right? So I don't manage any financial statement. Financial statement, okay? So I don't. The most important part here no sería como el resto, sino este elemento bien importante. I don't manage. Yo no manejo, yo no toco, okay? So yo no tengo nada que ver con estados financieros. So I don't manage that. Positive sentence, one more time, I check. Negative, solo le voy a agregar eso que dice, I don't, all right? I don't manage any financial statement. Now guys, tell me please, ¿qué son algunas cosas que ustedes no hacen? What are some things in the office that you don't do, all right? So I can say, for example, I type, okay, I make my presentations. Let's say, yeah, I make my material, okay? So algo que yo no hago is I don't go to the office, okay? So trabajo desde la casa. So I don't go to the office at all. No voy a la oficina, all right? So one more time, I don't go, I don't manage. Positiva, solo así. I make, I check. All right? Questions? Any question?
No, teacher.
No questions? Okay, please, si tienen preguntas en algún momento, let me know, I stop y puedo regresar. I'm okay with that, no worries. But si quiero que, como que, comprendamos esta parte y la podemos armar, right? So, everybody, please, ayúdenme solamente con negativas. Ayúdenme con cinco cosas que no hacen en su oficina. Let's be realistic. Cinco cosas que no hacen. Please, in the chat, ayúdenme en el chat para que sea más rápido, right? So I can also look at what you're doing. So I don't. ¿Qué es lo que no hacen en la oficina? What is it that you don't do? So help me in the chat, everybody, please.
De lo que no.
De las actividades que no hacen, the activities that you don't do. Las positivas ya las escribieron, so we are okay with that. Now vamos con las negativas. I don't, all right? I don't, okay. Es importante mencionar esto. Siempre necesito acá como un verbo, algo que le llamamos una acción. I don't manage. I don't go, okay. I don't make, okay. Siempre necesitamos un verbo. Si queremos guiarnos de la estructura gramatical, es como un sujeto, subject, luego va el don't, okay. Y luego siempre va el verbo, siempre, siempre, siempre. So we need at least these three elements. Así funciona. Subject, don't, and verb. I don't go, I don't eat. For example, yo no como. Cuando voy a la oficina, no puedo comer adentro de la oficina. So I don't eat at the office. In the office. Okay, no, no se puede comer adentro. I don't eat in the office, all right? So what are some activities that you don't do? I don't do the cleaning. Ah, okay, Jackie, that's okay. I don't watch movies. Yeah, imagine trabajando y viendo Netflix. So no, I don't watch Netflix. I don't watch a movie, okay. I don't buy the products. Okay, I don't clean my office. Uy, René, no, that's okay. I don't have, I don't hand. I don't manage. But quizás solamente que tengo el hand. Solo I don't manage money, and that's okay. I don't eat working, okay. I don't, Brian, that's okay. Agreguemosle quizás make. I don't make the financial statements or reports. Mm-hmm. I don't play, okay. Norberto, it's okay. Solo cambiamos el orden. I don't play soccer. I don't play, como el verbo. I don't play soccer. I don't dance in the office. Okay, okay. I don't do the payroll. All right, all right. Yes, me gustaría hacer la payroll. But I can, okay. So, exactly. So we use I don't. Okay.
¿Cómo se dice dormir?
Sleep. No, oh, very good. That's very good. No, guys, don't do this. I don't sleep. At the office. Don't do that. Pero también hay otra forma, you know? Es como tomar un descanso, como una. My goodness. ¿Cómo se llama eso? Like, you sleep for 1 hour? Una siesta. I don't take a nap. So I don't take a nap, all right. Take a nap is como tomar una siesta de 30 minutos, 40, una hora, you know. So I don't take a nap at the office. I can't, all right. I don't dear now. Danny, can you explain a little bit? Jocelyn says, I don't fight with the people. Oh, very good. I don't do reports. I don't go to the office in the, maybe in the afternoon, Patty? I think that was it. Danny, me ayuda con la última. I don't dear. I don't dear. What do you mean, Danny? I don't shout. Okay. No, but Danny, come on. So like, no muere en la oficina, he says. No, but not really. It's like, I don't break. Quizás agreguémosle como yo no tomo, no tomo recesos. I don't take breaks, Sandra. No sé si esa es la idea de no tomar recesos. I don't take breaks. No tomo recesos. Well, actually, yo tengo que decir que yo sí tomo recesos. So I take breaks, okay? So solamente le quito, digo, le agrego el don't y ya es negativo. So I don't take breaks. Okay, that's okay. ¿Estamos bien con el don't? Are we okay with this? I like this topic because it's like a lot of things. I don't drink beer in the office. Very good, Brian. Don't do it. Never, ever. Okay, that's all right. So this is at the office, okay? Hay muchas cosas que no podemos hacer, but we do it. For example, the cell phone. En algunos lugares es prohibido. I mean, it's totally, you know, banned to use your cell phone. So I don't use my cell phone when I'm working, yeah? I don't use my cell phone. So everybody, preguntas con el don't, o está super fácil? Yes.
Siempre gramaticalmente sería el sujeto, don't, verbo.
Verbo, correct.
Y
luego verbo, complemento, el resto, lo que usted quiera agregar. Pero siempre es como I don't. I don't eat, I don't dance, I don't study, I don't play, I don't clean, I don't dust, I don't, cualquier verbo, but I don't. Mm-hmm. Yes, gracias. That's the one. Okay, you're welcome.
Thanks.
Okay, everybody, vamos a hacer un ejercicio súper rapidito ahorita. Vamos a hacer un ejercicio de like 10 segundos, pero en esos 10 segundos me tiene que decir al menos 10 actividades que no hace, all right? ¿Cómo va a ser? Imagínense, 10 segundos, tiene que ser like quick, 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 okay? I don't, hablemos de la oficina o hablemos de su casa, lo que sea más fácil, ¿ok? In my house, I don't cook, I don't clean, I don't wash the dishes, I don't dust, I don't sweep, I don't mop, I don't have dogs, so I don't clean them, I don't water the plants, I don't wash my car, I don't, oh my God, I don't know, I don't make breakfast, I don't watch TV. That's it, okay? Al menos 10, so tiene que ser like super, super fast, okay? Escribámoslas. Practiquémoslas, all right? Y tienen 3 minutos para decirlas como lo más rápido que puedan, okay? The fastest you can. So, 3 minutes. 3 minutes. Pueden escoger entre su casa o la oficina, right? En la casa hay como más cosas de qué hablar. So, but you're good, you're okay. One more minute. Si ya los tienen, I would recommend you que los digan en voz alta, right? So repítanselos a ustedes en voz alta para que se escuchen. Okay, everybody. So I would like to have, I don't know if I have any volunteer or you prefer to be selected as a victim. So let the Hunger Games begin. So volunteers, do I have any volunteer? I don't see any hand up. Okay, so let me go and choose. Okay, I see Jocelyn. So Jocelyn is ready. Hey, Jocelyn, thank you so much. Okay, you can be the first volunteer and then you can select the next victim. That's totally good. Okay, Jocelyn, please. Ayúdeme, son vamos a bajarle a 5, right? Because 10 realmente toma tiempito. So let's go with 5. We are super good with 5. Lo más rápido que pueda. The fastest we can. Y luego reviste quién puede ser la siguiente persona, ¿ok? So, ya se le encuentra esta lista. Whenever you are ready.
I don't sleep. I don't watch my cell phone. I don't think with the people. I don't drink coffee. I don't take a break.
Yes, very good. Eso era at the office, right? En la oficina, yes. At the office. Perfect, very good. So you don't fight with people. Okay, you don't fight. That's good. Jocelyn, who's next? ¿Quién es el siguiente o la siguiente? Anybody.
Ingrid.
Ingrid. Ingrid is perfect. So Ingrid, let's go with you.
Oops, se me agarró en curva. Solo pude anotar 3.
Oh, it's okay, you're good, you're good.
Mm-hmm. I don't read. Mm-hmm. I don't reprimand. I don't sleep.
Okay, so you don't sleep, you don't read. And the third one is, I don't
reprimand. It's in home, at home.
I think I listened like, yo no.
No office is at home.
Yeah, la segunda que mencionó, la reprimand.
Yeah, reprimand, ajá.
Que se refiere como a que no regañar, me regañan.
No regañar, no regaño. En mi casa no regaño.
Oh, ok. Quizás podemos usar, no I don't reprimand.
Y no leo para nada hasta ahora.
I can be with you. Quizás podríamos usar la palabra scold, all right? So scold es como echar un regaño, that's okay. So we can just scold, all right? So no lee, not even Facebook,
porque
like
bien
anything.
Difícil.
The teacher, news, ajá. Uh-huh.
Teacher, es bien difícil decir, uno no hace nada, como no de mujer, no hace nada, no puedo decir, no hago limpieza, no hago esto, no hago comida, no hago eso, porque mentira, teacher.
No, that's totally true, I understand, because yo hago todo in my house, you know, pero por el, you know, por la práctica, digamos que no hacemos anything. Okay, thank you. Ingrid, you are next, select next person, please.
Okay, sería Jacqueline.
Jacqueline, all right. So where are you, Jacqueline?
Hey, teacher. I don't do the cleaning.
Okay.
I don't do reports. I don't sleep. I don't exercise. I don't use the cell phone in the office. I don't drink coffee.
Okay, very good. You don't drink coffee?
No.
What? I can't believe you. No, like, my friend. No. You don't like coffee? No, that's unbelievable. So no es de mi team, you know. I'm a coffee lover, so that's unbelievable. Well, thank you. Thank you, Jackie. That was a very good description. Okay, guys, so ¿cómo utilizamos o para qué usamos simple present tense? Precisamente para esto, para hablar de las actividades que hacemos. Algo que es como bien rutinario, right? Para hablar del las cosas que nos gustan, cosas que son hechos. I'm sorry about my neighbor's dog. Creo que logran escuchar al perrito de mi vecino. Sorry about that. Okay. Yeah, but it's, you know, let's ignore it. Okay. Now, vamos a usar un verbo que es bien útil, all right? Que es el verbo like. So vamos a mezclar, vamos a poner todito junto. Ahora positivas y negativas juntas. Vamos ahorita con I. Porque los demás pueden que nos tome un poco más de esfuerzo y trabajo poder explicarlo, right? So, ¿cómo utilizo el verbo like? Super easy, I like, okay? Y eso es todo. Cosas que nos gustan, I like, all right? Please, no vamos a poner otro verbo. This is very important. I like it, no se puede. Todos los verbos que ya los usaron, no se pueden. I like sleep, for example, no se puede. Solamente vamos a decir como las cosas que nos gustan. I like music, I like salsa, I like pupusas, okay, cosas que
I love coffee.
Gustan. I love coffee, it's not live, love. Yes, very good example, thank you. Now, cosas que no nos gustan, I don't like. Remember, no hablamos de actividades, sino de cosas, okay. Si digo, por ejemplo, no me gusta levantarme temprano, no, porque va a levantarse. So, esa es una acción. No se puede. No la vamos a poner ahorita. For example, I don't like, oh my God. Oh, I don't like cats. I hate, but literally I hate cats. I am not a cat lover.
Por dos.
Are you a cat lover, guys? Brian says no. What about the rest? Do you like cats?
I hate cats, miss.
But she hates them, you know. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry si alguien le gustan, you know, or you are the kind of person que los besan and everything. But back. If I see a cat, I'm like, yuck, you know, not really. So I love dogs, but I don't like cats, okay? So let's take a look one more time. I like, me gusta, right? Negativo sobre el griego, I don't like. Y eso es todo, that's it, okay? Si quiero usar otro verbo, no hay problema, es lo mismo. Quiero decir, por ejemplo, I hate, yo odio, okay? Es lo mismo, I hate reggaeton, okay? So cualquier verbo es lo mismo, si se fijan. Sujeto, verbo, right? Y si es negativo, siempre va sujeto y luego don't, I don't. Vamos a usar este verbo right now. I like and I don't like. Pero para esto, vamos a irnos a los grupos. We are going to join the groups. Y vamos a hacer como una listita de lo que nos gusta. Please, tomemos nota, okay? Tomen nota. Por ejemplo, I don't know, Ingrid says, oh, I like this, I like that, porque lo vamos a usar no para la sesión de ahora, sino para la de mañana, all right? So, tomen nota de quién les dice qué es lo que les gusta, qué es lo que no les gusta, all right?
Vamos. Teacher, en las oraciones, cuando mencionamos el objeto, no hay que decir, digamos, the music, no hay que solo mencionar música y se entiende qué es la música.
I have to be very honest. Hay como reglas para utilizar the. So, por ejemplo, si usted quiere decir me gusta la salsa, que por cierto a mí no me gusta, I can say
I love the salsa.
No, really, I love cumbiones, but no salsa. Okay. I can say, for example, I like salsa music, and it's totally fine. Quizás no podría, no sería necesario que digamos I like the salsa music, all right? Con salsa music se entiende, so we understand. A menos que sea algo como bien específico, entonces usamos the. But right now, it's not necessary. Por ejemplo, I can say, I like...
Yo tengo cuatro palabras. Por ejemplo, perro, árboles y una manzana.
Okay, this is the point. Si tiene, por ejemplo, perros, si yo digo, I like dogs, usted ya generalizó que todos los perros, all right? Si usted dice the, tiene que ser bien específico. I like the dog. Ok. Es como, me gusta solo este, pero solo este. Entonces, es un poquito diferente. No sé si lo confundo. Más adelante ustedes van a ver las reglas de cada uno de estos temas. Right now, quizás vámonos como con más generalidades. Porque sí necesitamos ver como las reglas del uso de the. Perdón, escuché a alguien que me dijo Miss, but I'm not sure.
Sí, yo acerca de lo mismo que él estaba preguntando. Por ejemplo, yo puse I like the animals, but I don't like cats.
That's good. Yeah, that's very good. I like the animals is good, and I don't like cats. Es bien generalizado. No me gusta ninguno, right? That's okay. Yeah, that's good. I don't like cats, believe me.
Ninguno.
No, no, really. I mean, I see the pictures and I'm like, oh, no.
De lo que se pierde, teacher.
Do you like cats?
De lo que se pierde, teacher.
Oh, I know.
De gatitos y perritos.
I mean, they have a cute face. They have a really cute, they have cute eyes. But I'm like, oh, no way. Creo que nunca tendría uno, you know. Okay, everybody. So, hablamos de lo que nos gusta, lo que no nos gusta. Remember, vamos a tomar nota porque mañana lo vamos a usar, all right? So, in order to talk, necesitamos practicar. So, deme un segundito. Vamos a ir a hablar con los compañeros. We are going to be talking with our classmates. Me one second. Ahí estamos, okay? So, escuchemos a los compañeros. Y vamos a usar, ahorita no vamos a preguntar, no le van a preguntar qué te gusta, right? Podemos hacerlo bien general y ustedes empiezan a contar. What do you like? What do you like? ¿So qué te gusta? O simplemente le cuentan al compañero qué le gusta y qué no les gusta. So, give me one second. Les envío la invitación and let's join. We have only 5 minutes. So 5 minutes, go and then come back. Doo-doo-doo.
Smash watch is
watch.
Gabi, what do you like?
I like coffee. I like dogs. I like read books. Okay. No sé cómo decir si es me gusta, I like la de playa o sería I love beach.
Both are okay. Todo depende del grado. I like or I love, you know. So it depends. ¿Le gusta o le encanta? So,
that's me encanta.
Oh, so okay. I like the beach. It's like, yeah, yeah. And I love. It's like algo que realmente me gusta. So I like or I love. Ambas están bien. Todo depende de usted. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Solo de filosofía.
Ok.
Ok, I like beer, I like whiskey, I like Wendy's, I like sushi, I like dogs, I like chocolate, I like women, I like play soccer, I love you, Coca-Cola, I like my job. I don't like smoke. I don't like avocado. I don't like green mango. I don't like cats. I don't like beer. That's it.
Sorry.
Also, I don't like turtles. And you, Moises?
And you, Miriam, what do you do? Why?
Yes, solo permítame un segundito.
Okay, Miriam.
Usted, Moises.
Okay, okay. No sé quién va a decir ahorita.
Usted, Miriam.
You, Miriam.
Okay. I like pizza, I like pizzas, I like Pepsi, I like those. I like Coldplay band, I like chocolate. No sé si alguno de ustedes sabe cómo se dice naturaleza. No recuerdo.
Environment, creo que es naturaleza.
Okay, no me recuerdo cómo se llama. Ah, naturaleza. Nature, gracias.
Nature.
Gracias, compañero.
Natural. Natural, I was.
Yeah, that's nature. So I like nature. Mm-hmm.
Nature. Nature.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't like cats. I hate reggaeton. Y I don't coffee.
Okay.
Okay. I like beer. I like coffee. I like pizza. I like pupusas. I like dry. I like Pepsi. I don't like cats. I don't like clean. I don't like rum. I don't like snakes. I hate snakes.
I hate all the insects. Repeat, who is Ron? No, dijo Ron, algo así. I don't like.
I think he said like running, like I don't like running, Moises.
Huh? Correct.
Rum.
Rum.
Like la bebida alcohólica, right?
Rum.
Ajá, o running, like running, de hacer ejercicio, de correr.
Yeah.
O las dos.
Solo correr.
Okay, so he was running, okay. So he doesn't like running, no le gusta correr. Okay, okay.
Don't like snake.
Hi everybody, did you finish? Yes, is everybody done? Yes. Okay, very good. Did you take notes? Escribieron, tomaron nota, did you write it down? Yeah.
Yes,
perfect.
Yes.
Keep your notes. Guardemos las notitas que las vamos a utilizar mañana. Give me 1 second y vamos a regresar a la sesión. Hold on. Okay, everybody, welcome back. Esperamos un par de segundos mientras todos los demás compañeros regresen, right? In the meantime, tell me, ¿qué es lo que los compañeros le dijeron que no les gusta o lo que les gusta, que les ha llamado la atención? Anything that you remember? Any new word that you remember?
Gabby, she don't like water.
Water. What?
Yes.
Okay.
Why?
No lleva algún químico o algo, no me gusta.
Ah, okay. Oh. Okay. So, what do you mean? No le gusta como el agua no filtrada, let's say.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
¿El agua de qué?
Digamos el agua de chorro or something like that.
En realidad toda no me gusta, solo la que
lleva. What do you mean? Okay, pero si toma agua, do you drink water?
Un vaso al día.
No, Gabby, your kidneys, sus riñones.
Yo sé.
Okay, well, yeah, I mean. Something that I do with the water, you know, es que le pongo como gotitas de limón sometimes, or pedacitos de pepino o de fresa, como pedacitos, y sabe bien rica. So maybe, maybe así.
Yes.
Because weather is super important. Yeah, eso sí me ha dejado, you know, in shock. I didn't know, okay.
No le creemos, no le creemos, no tuviera nada.
Yeah, okay. Well, the thing is that I normally do exercise, entonces sí es como, if I don't drink water, el cuerpo, you know, ya me siento super, super down. So, but okay, but I think it's important. Okay, anything else, guys? Algo más que los haya tomado de sorpresa, and you say, what?
Patty, she don't like red pencil.
She doesn't like? El que, perdón, que yo repeat?
Red pencil.
Okay. Patty, but is that the color? Like, you don't like that color? I think Patricia.
I don't like, como pencil red.
But like, or the pen.
Okay, pen red. Es, tengo algo así como, no sé, veo algo escrito así con rojo y es como, no sé, no me gusta.
Ah, okay. Quizás traumas de bachillerato y las notas. No, yo
sí. Igual que a mí, teacher.
Me
pasa lo mismo. A mí solo el lapicero azul me gusta.
Ah, okay.
No me gusta el rojo tampoco.
Okay. Well, I prefer to use.
Pero nada supera que a Gaby no le guste el agua, por Dios.
Sí, en serio.
Sí.
Eso es preocupante, compañera.
No, I'm like still in shock. Okay, but I mean, it's just fine.
Marvin,
kidneys.
Están 10 de 10 con 5 tazas de café diarias.
Your kidneys.
Your kidneys are crying. I saw Marvin with a bottle of water. No, I mean, but honestly, yeah, water is super important. Mm-hmm. I mean, con lo que sea, right? But yeah, we should. Okay. So, algo que supere lo de Gaby.
Nothing.
Nah, just kidding. We got water. No cats, no dogs, no turtles. Brian dijo que no le gustaban las turtles. Let me see. Anything else? He doesn't like turtles. Creo que I don't remember what else I heard. Algo más, compañeros. What else?
I don't work in...
You don't like cleaning, like limpiar nada. You don't like cleaning. Okay, I think somebody said I don't like reggaeton. I think that was
media. I don't
know.
It's hospital.
You don't like hospitals.
I don't know hospital.
You don't like hospitals. I don't like hospitals.
La jeringas.
I love hospital.
You love hospitals, really?
Yes.
But why?
Porque cuando era chiquita quería estudiar medicina.
Ay, nice. Okay. Pero está súper joven. Todavía puede seguir ese sueño. You can follow
yes.
that. Mm-hmm. That is something achievable. Nice. I mean, I don't mind going to hospitals, pero quizás no me gusta like el olor de hospital. So I would say not the place, but the smell. All right. I don't like the smell.
Teacher, en la noche tampoco no es un buen olor hospital. En la noche no.
I don't know, probably si alguno ha estado ingresado, you can tell us, right? Like, si se siente
no lo niego, teacher, que estar ingresado en el hospital lo tratan súper bien a veces. A mí me han tratado súper bien.
Nice.
O sea, a veces me han dado ganas de quedarme, pero...
pero le dijeron, vaya.
Aviso cuál hospital fue para ir también y que me atiendan así, porque si no recuerden ninguno.
¿Por qué, compañera Patty, de que cuando yo tuve a mis hijas me trataron súper nice y es la única parte donde yo puedo esperar que alguien haga algo por mí?
Okay. Well, probably hospitals.
Okay.
Probably hospitals, but not seguro
sí,
social,
en mi casa,
right?
Todo lo tengo
I like necroporties.
You don't like?
No, I like.
Can you repeat? What is something that you like, you said?
Necroporties.
Oh, at night. Okay.
Yeah.
The tourism that is done at night, to cemeteries. Okay. Okay. Sounds good. Sounds good. Now, everybody, follow this lead. Let's take a look at the following thing. How to use simple present? Vamos a basarlo en lo mismo. We have subject, we have verb, and then we have the complement, the rest of the information. Negative. Negative, sí, es un poquito like tricky, let's say. Porque negative usamos don't para I, you, we, and they. All right, so I, two, three, four. Four different pronouns con los que vamos a combinar el don't. I keep tracks, I don't keep track. You know, you don't know. We advertise, you don't advert, we don't advertise. They help, they don't help. Positivo, negativo, all right? Solo le agrego don't. No le voy a agregar nada más que eso. Now let's take a look at the following. Unscramble the sentences with the words provided using simple present. Vamos a ponerlas en orden, okay? It says here, keep the company's track financial account, etc. Vamos a ponerlas en orden. Vamos a poner cada letra para armar una oración. ¿Cómo se arman las oraciones? Fácil. Primero busquemos el sujeto. Ese es el primer elemento. I, you, we, they. O si tenemos nombres, pues los nombres, right, de las personas. So, for example, en vez de tener he, tengo a Giovanni. En vez de tener they, tengo a Ingrid y a Brian. So, busquemos primero el sujeto, luego buscan el verbo. ¿Cuál es el verbo? For example, keep, know, advertise, help, eat, sleep, drink, etc. Y así la vamos formando, all right? So, tienen un par de minutitos para terminarla. Si alguien tiene la primera, me ayuda en el chat, right? Para que todos los demás podamos ir viendo. And so, we move on. Si alguien tiene dudas de por qué está así, you know, let me know y así revisamos todos juntos. So, chicos, comenzamos a trabajar. Let's start working on it. Y les pueden compartir en el chat o activan el micrófono y la dicen oralmente, right? Si ya creen que la tienen, it's okay, activan el micrófono. We can also do that. Okay, so I think Giovanni has number two. We don't advertise the company on the internet. We don't advertise the company. Yeah. Yes, Giovanni, thank you so much. Very good. That is number two. Yep, there we go. Okay, so Brian says number one. I think that's number one, right? They keep track of financial accounts companies. They keep track. Almost Brian, almost number one, pero le falta algo, le faltan dos cositas pequeñitas ahí. Miriam, what is that one? Miriam, number three, I believe. I take notes. in the meeting every day. Yes, that's okay. Very good. I take notes in the meetings every day. Mm-hmm. We are missing number four. Y un poquito de la número uno todavía. We are missing a little something. So number four, Ana says, Carlos and Mauricio answer phone. So it's like Carlos and Mauricio answered phone at the reception. Yes, Ana, that's very good. So nos falta solamente la número uno. We are missing only number one. Yes, Jocelyn, that's all right. What about number one? Number one, si nos fijamos acá, dice un número dos. That means que la palabra of se utiliza dos veces. We use it two times. So that is lo que nos estaba haciendo falta. We were missing that little something. So number one, ¿quién tiene la uno? ¿O cómo tiene la uno? How do you have it? All right, so yeah, exactly. They keep track of financial account of companies. Yes, there we go. Okay, everybody, very good. That's very, very nice. So this is positive, okay? These are the things that we normally do. And como estamos hablando, parte de lo que hacemos every single day, vamos a incluir también nuestra rutina, okay? So this is part of the routine, okay, that we do. Imagine, de lunes a viernes hacen como lo mismo en la oficina, I think. Almost everybody does the same activities. What happens? La rutina de sábado y domingo. What is your Friday and Sunday routine? Okay, so what do you do? So what do you do on Saturday? Hey guys, what do you do on Saturday? Or what do you do on Sunday? ¿Qué hacen el fin de semana? What do you do on Sunday? For example, let me tell you this. Quiero decir que el domingo no trabajo. Okay, so on Sunday, ¿cómo digo no trabajo? How can I say no trabajo domingo? On Sunday?
I don't on Sunday.
Ajá, no trabajo. Acabamos de ver el no. All right, acabamos de revisar.
I don't work.
On Sunday. Yes, on Sunday I don't work. O le cambio el orden y está bien, es lo mismo. I don't work on Sunday. Okay, that's okay. So I don't work on Sunday. So ¿qué hacen? What do you do? In my case, I can tell you, me levanto tarde. I get up late. All right. Y me toca hacer toda la lavada de la semana. So I wash my, well, actually, no tanto a mano, sino bien la lavadora. So I do the laundry, okay? I don't wash that much. I do the laundry. So uso la lavadora, okay? I cook. I make breakfast. My sister makes lunch, but I make breakfast, okay? My TV is broken, so no veo televisión. I don't watch TV. Probably
because
Oh, okay. I don't watch TV because, porque está arruinado. Because it is broken. Mm-hmm. So I don't watch TV because it is broken. So, and if you pay attention, vamos formando ya otro tipo de actividades, okay? So this is what do you do on Saturday or what do you do on Sunday? So please, I want you to write a short description. Escojan el día que, you know, that you prefer, Saturday and, or Sunday. Y vamos a decir qué es lo que hacemos. What do you do these days? Escojan cualquiera. Choose any of them. At the moment, les voy a pedir que tomemos nota, right? Para que vayamos como diciéndole a nuestro cerebro cómo vamos a formar las oraciones. Para que luego las podamos practicar. All right? So let's do it, guys. Saturday or Sunday. Cualquiera de los dos. Okay, guys, one more minute. Podemos incluir cosas también que no hacen. Por ejemplo, I don't watch TV. No salgo. I don't go out, all right? No me baño. I don't take a shower. So I don't know, any activity that applies for Saturday or Sunday, all right? The idea is to practice vocabulary. Ok, everybody, si ya lo tenemos listo, tienen 2-3 minutitos más para poder practicarlo. Les voy a pedir que para este ejercicio le metamos como un poquito de energía, right? Intentemos, de ser posible, no leerlo, sino decirlo, solo decirlo de forma natural, all right? That means, no es necesario memorizarlo, sino, por ejemplo, ya sé cómo se dice, yo no trabajo, entonces, oh, I don't work on Saturday, I don't work on Sunday. Ya, ya no es necesario que me lo memorice tal cual. Me levanto tarde, I get up late. So, oh, I get up late, okay. Lavo la ropa, por ejemplo, I do the laundry or I wash my clothes, right? Oh, I make breakfast and I don't watch TV because it is broken. And that's it, okay? So the idea is no leerlo tanto, you know, but intentar decirlo, try to say it, try to say it. Tenemos 2-3 minutitos. Léanlo en voz alta ahí donde están, you know, and try to say it, and repeat it, please. One more minute. ¿Alguien tiene preguntas con el vocabulario? Do you have any question with the vocabulary? Miss, oh, estamos super bien.
Miss, yes, miss, I have a question.
Tell me, what is your question?
How do you say tomo una siesta in English?
I take a nap. I'm going to write it in the chat.
Okay.
That is, I take a nap. Yep. I take a nap.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome. Tell me, Danny.
What did you say? Como dice la compañera, es, ¿cómo se dice?
How do you así. Say? Mm-hmm. How do you say? I'm going to write it in the chat as well.
Muy,
yeah, how do you say?
Muy importante saber eso.
Yes. Yes, 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 of course. So how do you say and what is the meaning of? What is the meaning of? ¿Qué significa? So what is the meaning of?
Siesta.
There you go. So how do you say es como se dice? Okay, everybody, time is over. So everybody, time is over. We are going to get started. And antes estábamos con Jocelyn. We listened to a couple of you guys, pero quiero escucharlos a todos. So let me start with Renee. Renee, you are my first volunteer of this round. So please tell us, what do you do on Saturday or Sunday? Y luego ya vaya pensando quién va a ser la siguiente persona. Go ahead, Renee.
On Sunday, I get up late. And I, next, I cook my breakfast. And I go to the... I cook my breakfast. I take a shower. And next, I take a nap.
Okay.
Then I call with my mother, and I go to the play football with my friend. And next, I return on my house. I regreso a mi casa.
Yeah, I go back to my house. Mm-hmm.
I go to my house, and I brush my shoes, and I brush, and I go to the bed.
Okay. Very good. Emojis for Renee, guys. Come on. Let's share some love with him. That was very good, Renee. Very good description. I like it. I like how fluent you sound. I like your vocabulary. Solamente ayúdenme con esta palabrita. Bueno, de hecho, todos, help me with this little word. I'm going to write here in the chat. That is this one, okay? So, please, everybody, repitamos. Tooth.
Tooth.
Tooth. Okay. Ahora esta.
Teeth.
Okay, so this is tooth and teeth.
Tooth and teeth.
All right, I brush my teeth.
Brush my teeth.
That's it, exactly. All right, thank you. But besides that, Renee, that was awesome. Renee, you are the one to choose the next person. So, ¿quién es el siguiente? Who is going to be the next
person? Brian.
Your brother?
Who? Brian.
Oh, Brian. Okay, Brian. There you go, Brian. You're the chosen one. So, Brian, let's go.
Okay, on Sunday, I get out late, I watch football and sky, I take a shower, I brush my teeth, I don't breakfast, I eat cocktail and beer every Sunday. I drink whiskey every Sunday. That's it. I don't remember.
Thank you. That was very nice. That was very good. Very fluent, Brian. I like it. Brian me ha mentido, you know. In the previous activity, you said you don't like beer. And now it's like, oh.
No,
just kidding. No, that was very good. That was a very good description. Thank you. Brian, who's next? Alguien que no le haya escuchado ahora, please.
Déjeme ver si está conectado. Marvin.
Marvin. Yeah, lo acabo de ver. But I'm not sure. Marvin, are you with us?
Ahorita.
There you go. Yes.
Solo me voy a poner aquí. Para leer.
Okay. Don't read it. Try to say it. Let's do it.
Okay. My day off can be Saturday or Sunday.
Okay.
If I rest on Saturday, mm-hmm. I visit the panoramic road, for example.
Wow.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's
solamente.
It. Sí. Okay, that's it. Thank you. That was very nice. What is your favorite place in the panoramic road?
Coffee Lake.
Coffee.
Y hay uno que se llama el Cerrito Panorámico.
El Cerrito Panorámico. All right.
Café Santa Cruz.
I have been there, and that's a beautiful place, like a very nice view. And there is another one, Las Tres Piedras, I think.
Yes.
Yeah, that's also a very nice place. Guys, ¿han ido por ahí? Have you ever gone there?
Yes.
Okay, and what about the rest? ¿Han ido alguna vez a la Ruta Panorámica? Have you been there? En René says no. Marvin, ¿por qué no lo ha llevado? Oh my God,
no?
Marvin.
Si se lo pasa.
Really? Jackie, have you ever been there? ¿Ha ido alguna vez a la Ruta Panorámica?
No, teacher.
You know, you should. No está tan lejos. It's actually very close to San Salvador and it's not expensive. Bueno, yo siento que no, right? What do you think? Is it expensive? ¿Es cara?
Me dio la excursión eso.
Creo que
en Atiquizaya vive ella, teacher.
Really? Jackie, do you live in Atiquizaya? Wait, guys.
Yeah.
I think everybody was from the main area here. So I got, no, but that's too far away. Nunca he ido. I have never been to Atiquizaya, so I have no idea. Okay, so guys, is everybody from San Salvador? Todos son de acá de San Salvador. Okay, yes. René says yes.
No, teacher, I am Ahuachapán City.
Okay, so you live in Ahuachapán, and Jackie in Atiquizaya.
I live in Ahuachapán.
Oh, Ana lives in Ahuachapán. Oh, yes, as well as Giovanni, I remember, that is Santa Ana.
Danny,
right?
And Norberto is in Santa Ana.
Norberto was in Zacatecoluca, I think. Norberto, where do you live?
I live in Paraíso Osorio, Department La Paz.
Yeah, that's La Paz. That was not Zacatecoluca, but La Paz. Okay, that's La Paz. Moises, do you live in San Salvador?
Yes, I live in San Salvador.
Okay. Patty, what about you, Patty? San Salvador as well?
Yes, I live in San Salvador.
Okay,
yes.
So that's San Salvador. Danny?
Hello, in Santa Ana City.
Okay, so I got 2, 3, 4, 5 from Santa Ana. Okay, Jocelyn and Daisy, what about you girls?
I live in San Salvador.
Okay, and Daisy?
I live in San Salvador too.
All right, so I got some from Santa Ana as well. Gabby, are you from San Salvador as well?
Yes, I live in San Salvador.
Okay, Sandra? What about you, Sandra?
I live in San Salvador, teacher.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So we have only Santa Ana and San Salvador. Okay, but either way. So guys from Santa Ana, if you ever had the opportunity to go to La Ruta Panorámica, you should. It's a very nice view. And guys, deberíamos de ir a esa ruta también de las flores. That's a very nice view as well. That's a very
nice
excursion.
Sería bueno. Yeah. Sería bueno.
That would be nice. That would be super nice. Una excursión, they said. Okay, that would be very cool. But, you know, I think it's a little hard sometimes.
Para la primera graduación del curso. Además de hacer una excursión.
The thing is that it's a little hard. Es bien difícil or coordinarse con tiempos. But that would be very cool. That would be very cool. Guys, antes de irnos, regálenme un par de minutitos solamente. Voy a pasar asistencia. Algunos se me quedaron del control número uno y no quiero... No, que se me vayan sin pasar asistencia. Dear, así que give me one second here. Solamente para el día de mañana, siempre me ayuden, you know, con la tarea. Tenemos la tarea número 6, al igual que la discusión número 6, right? And ya les voy a colocar la discusión para que la puedan completar, lo cual es súper cortita. Deme un segundito solamente. Okay. I got Brenda está por acá. Brian también, right? Está Brian. Cindy, no veo a Cindy. Daisy Lorena, Daisy está con nosotros. Gabriela Alejandra también, right? Let me see. Jacqueline también is back and Marvin is also back. Okay, creo que los demás ya les había tomado asistencia. Yeah, I had already taken some attendance here. Okay, everybody, look, nuevamente agradecerles a todos por la tarea. Estaba revisando, les comentaba al inicio, el reporte de tareas. Y súper buen trabajo, you know, I'm super, super happy también con el reporte de asistencia. Gracias a los que estaban desde bien tempranito, you know, conectados los 60 minutos. Recordarles que InstaFort nos pide no solamente la conexión, ¿verdad? Sino que son 120 minutos completos en nuestro caso, right? Así que mil gracias porque sí, nuestros reportes están súper, súper bien. Yo sé que es un esfuerzo, que ya tenemos sueño, you know, ya casi nos vamos, give me one second. Y yo sé que va a valer la pena, you know, todo el sacrificio that you're making y la desvelada and everything. So, homework for tomorrow. La tarea número 6 es para mañana y discusión número 6, all right? Intentemos llevarla así como juntitas para que no nos vayamos atrasando. Brian, tell me.
Tengo una duda, referente a lo de los miércoles, los grupos serían, ¿usted nos avisaría?
Correcto, ya les, el día de mañana, sí, para la discusión, nosotros siempre rotamos para que todos tengan como la oportunidad de clarificar alguna duda con los temas, especialmente porque nos vamos moviendo bastante rápido. El día de mañana yo les comparto la lista de quienes están programados para este día, miércoles. Si alguien tiene como alguna dificultad en conectarse, solamente me lo hace saber antes, you know, para ver si podemos como hacer un cambio, ¿verdad? Si usted no puede a esa hora, tal vez alguien más puede y lo cambiamos, pero sí, me notifican antes para estar pendientes. Creo que este viernes anterior alguien tuvo dificultades con la conexión, no se pudo conectar. Ya voy a verificar quién fue para ver de qué manera igual le programamos y no se pierda la oportunidad de clarificar dudas, right? ¿Eso, chicos? Dígame.
Sí, yo no me pude conectar el miércoles pasado.
Sí, recuerdo que alguien se me había quedado como con la pantalla congelada, ¿verdad? Entonces, déjeme ver en qué momento yo lo puedo ingresar y ya le comento si se puede esta semana o si no hasta la próxima. Okay. Thank you, Norberto. Okay, everybody, so thank you so much for your time. Ya son las 10 de la noche. Enjoy, ya no les robo ningún minuto el día de ahora. Okay, siempre les robo tiempo. So bye, everybody, have a wonderful night and thank you for your time. See you tomorrow.
See you, miss. Good night.
Bye, teacher. Bye, my friend. Bye.